with the Zombie 8E I got a really powerful RC car from my sponsor GearBest. Same as its predecessors, I will also transform the Zombie into a browser-controlled robot car. Because of the large dimensions and the powerful motor, this is a great chassis to implement lots of payloads such as sensors, actuators or cameras. In this first video about the Zombie, I will have a closer look at the construction and evaluate what has to be considered when transforming the car. Details about the conversion to a browser-controlled vehicle and about implementing add-ons is treated in more videos about this robotics project. The dimensions are 52x33x21cm and the weight including the drive battery is 3600 grams, it's for sure no tiny chassis for a robot. The diameter of the wheels is 15cm, resulting in a ground clearance of approximately 6cm, so this car is made for rough terrain. Included in the package is a lightweight plastics body with a spoiler, the drive battery with a charger and the remote control in pistol grip design. Receiver, battery, motor and controller are all mounted on the chassis, it's ready to run, there is nothing to be wired up. Motor, controller and receiver are in plastic boxes so that the electronics is protected from splash water, the Zombie is not made for driving fully underwater. The cooling fan on top of the motor controller is no silent device. The rear wheels are connected through a torsion bar and it's a construction with a long spring travel. Same is true for the front wheels. You can adjust the springs with the nut. And also change the upper mount point of the shock absorbers to get either a large ground clearance or a lower center of gravity. All four wheels are driven by one brushless motor type 3670 with 2030 revolutions per minute per volt. Joints along the drive shaft compensate the shift in height from motor through front and rear differential to the wheels. There are three differential gears in total, forwarding the motor power to the four wheels. Those differentials allow the wheels to spin with different speeds, occurring for example when driving around a corner. The car is almost ready to drive, only the four wheels have to be mounted. The copper-colored wheel nuts made of anodized aluminum are tightened with the plastics tool that is included in the kit. The 3S drive battery has a nominal output voltage of 11.1 volts and a capacity of 2600 mAh, the Zombie ships with a charger for lithium polymer batteries having 2 or 3 cells. It's no power charger, the maximum current is no more than 1 amp. With that it takes almost 4 hours until the battery is fully charged, indicated by the second LED turning green. The remote control needs 4 AA batteries that are not included in the package. After turning on the remote control and connecting the drive battery, the Zombie is ready for action. At the first start of the car you should calibrate the throttle which is done by pushing a button while turning the main switch, release that button immediately after turning the switch. A permanent beep sound indicates that the motor controller is prepared for calibration. Push the button again with the throttle in neutral position, a beep sound confirms that step. Pull the throttle to front and push the button again, two beep sounds confirm that position as well. Now push the throttle to rear and push the button, three beep sounds confirm that position. When releasing the trigger, another three beep sounds confirm the end of the calibration. Now you can control the motor in forward, and reverse direction. The controller has a built-in brake functionality. When coasting after driving forward without braking, you must push the throttle twice to go into reverse direction. With the potentiometer on the remote control you can adjust the neutral position of the steering. A second potentiometer can be used to adjust the steering limits, so that you get either a tight turning circle or a better directional stability. With the switch you can reverse the direction of steering. You can adjust the throttle in a similar way. With the lower potentiometer you can adjust the neutral position, same as with the steering. The upper potentiometer is for dual rate functionality, limiting the throttle. You eventually have to readjust the neutral position after turning the dual rate knob, at least when you are not able to go in reverse. Limiting the throttle makes driving slowly more easy. You can also reverse the functionality of the throttle lever by a switch. Even with all four wheels in the air, the motor draws a current of more than 7 amps. When accelerating with the wheels in the air, the current increases to more than 30 amps. High electric power is converted into mechanical power. The maximum voltage of the motor is listed with 14.8 volts, the empty load current with 4 amps. Let's go out for a test drive. As you can see, the Zombie is a really powerful model car. I have printed a holder for my smartphone and installed an app to measure the maximum speed of the car. The top speed on my test track is 45.5 km per hour. With a mass of 3.6 kg we get a kinetic energy of 287 joule, that's in the Zombie at full speed. That might cause an expensive impact crater if you hit an object. The Zombie is no toy for the kids, but a tiny racing car for the big boys. With the sturdy chassis, the soft tires and the good suspension, you don't have to worry about getting airborne with the Zombie. However, two hard landings will set marks on the chassis. The list of spare parts is long, so that you can at least repair the Zombie after an accident. I am no skilled RC car driver, nonetheless the car survived all test runs without any damage on the mechanics. I only lost one screw of the suspension, so don't forget to check if all parts are tightened before going out on the track. The idea behind ordering the Zombie was to transform the car into a browser-controlled robot with good off-road capabilities. When steering a robot with an internet browser thousands of miles away just like a rover on a distant planet, you must drive slowly. With dual rate enabled, you can drive the Zombie slowly with ease, at least on a flat surface. The four-wheel drive with a large ground clearance gives the car good off-road capabilities. However, driving slowly is more tricky on rough terrain. Full throttle is needed every now and then, but what the Zombie jumps forward immediately because of the powerful motor. Especially in reverse direction, the throttle is tricky to handle. That's getting even more tricky if you are in extremely rough terrain, and another issue in low speed driving is caused by the differentials. Whenever a wheel loses contact to ground, most of the drive energy is forwarded to the wheel that's in the air. The zombie is made for fast driving and that's where differentials are needed to give the car a better stability. A braking system is also needed to stop the car from rolling downhill whenever the motor is disabled. You can solve those problems either mechanically or by adding sensors and electronics. In the first scenario you can simply lock the differentials mechanically and add a larger gear ratio to the drive. The later case is challenging, you'll need to sense the angular velocity of the wheels and activate mechanical brake systems. I have added 2 lead acid batteries with a total mass of 1100 grams on the chassis and as you can see, the zombie is powerful enough to carry that extra payload with ease. There is also enough space on the chassis to add sensors or actuators. The reasonably priced model car is a great base for a robot with good off-road capabilities and as you can see, I did not handle the zombie gently during my test runs. Steering and motor are controlled by pulse width signals, so a microcontroller can be used to generate the needed signals. A Raspberry Pi can be used as central brain of the remote controlled robot car. More about the conversion of the zombie to another browser-controlled robot is written on my pages. That's where you can drive this monster truck whenever the batteries are charged and the vehicle is online. Besides the zombie, more robots are running in my RoboStadium 24 hours a day and you can drive them for free. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.